Hey everybody, welcome back to Head Trip Air World Tour. Thanks for joining us, and hope you've been following along. For the last several episodes, we've been trying to move this tour along. Kind of stuck a little bit in Brazil. Actually, we've been stuck in Brazil for quite a while, but no longer. We had a really great flight late last night, but really it was wee into the hours of the morning. I decided just to take a quick 50-minute flight. Didn't expect much out of it, and lo and behold, we got that Dark Star to land, and that was my first landing of the Dark Star coming out of the stratosphere ever, and it was awesome. For me, it was awesome. So that means we get to move this thing forward. We get to keep moving. Excited about that. We're back in our PMDG Boeing 737-800, and we're going to take this from French Guiana, where we now reside, up to Suriname to finish out one of the two last countries of South America. After Suriname, we'll be heading up to Guiana, and then most likely to Trinidad from there, and from where we go at that point, nobody knows. Maybe the Eastern Caribbean Islands, maybe over to Africa, possibly up to Europe, maybe to Bermuda, and then up to Canada and Greenland and Iceland. But I don't know. Or maybe we just like go bat crap crazy and turn around and fly down to Australia or New Zealand, I don't know. But we don't need to worry about that right now, because we do need to finish up South America. But I'm starting to see a light at the end of the tunnel. I think we're getting there, guys. By the way, we do have a special guest that'll be joining us on Thursday for our 100th episode. Episode 100, believe it or not, I'll be honest, I can't believe I'm still doing this. 100 episodes. I have to be like one of the very few channels on YouTube that has 100 episodes with less than 30 subscribers and really less than probably 3 or 2 active viewers at any given time. I think that's an excellent feat. Really proud of that accomplishment. And so, anyways, this is what we do around here. The further we get, the more exciting it gets. Maybe we'll have some programmatic activity at some point in time, but right now we got to just focus on getting this flight up in the air and back down safely. So let's do that. Let's get the bird lit up, and we'll be in the air in no time at all. Okay. Now, I haven't flown this plane that much, so hopefully things go well. First things first, though, let's get some ground services, and we'll bring in a GPU cart to get some external power. I really need to set up some good camera shortcuts or get a good camera add-on, but I still haven't done that. Don't know why. Ground power is available, so we'll turn that on. There we go. And we got a battery. I'm going to go ahead and turn my position lights to strobe and steady, and I'm going to turn on the anti-collision. I'll leave the wing and well off. I think I will turn on my logo light, though. Don't think I'll need it, but, you know, it's kind of a vanity thing, I guess. And then I think we're ready to start focusing on our APU. Now, in order to get the APU working here, get the pressure, we do need to enable the first fuel pump. And that is a fuel pump in the aft, or the butt of the plane, like you like to say. And I think we're ready to kick this into gear. What do you say? Very shortly, we should be seeing a little bit of activity on this cage. Gets a little bit of pressure, and things should work out just fine. And looks like they are. While that's going, I'm going to come up here to our IRS, get that started, align those, there we go, APUs going to go up to about, let's see, come back down here, there we go, APU is going to go up to 7, and then it's going to swing back down and settle in around 4 and stabilize. And then what we'll do is we will get the rest of the fuel pumps on and prepare to move air into the engines and get those started up. There we go. Now with the APU running just fine, I think what we can do is, I don't think I'll start the generator until I get the engines going. No reason to tax resources. So I will, at this point in time, we need to open up the rest of the fuel. I don't think I have any fuel in the center tank, at least to my knowledge, so we're going to leave those off. And we'll go ahead and turn our hydraulics on too. I'm not sure 100% if I'm supposed to do that yet, or I wait till the engines are started, but they're on now. And we gotta get the APU bleed on. Okay, so down, down. These can all stay up. I don't know if they need to be up, but I definitely think these two need to be up, the pack. And let's get our engine starter over to the left, put it on ground, and let's see if we get any pressure down here. See if we get a little bit of spin up. Okay. And I forgot exactly how high that needs to go before we open up the fuel line. But I think I'll do it about now. Looks like life will start coming out of that left engine. Okay, I'm gonna see if we can get rid of those stairs. Let's move our ground power first. I'm gonna move our ground power over to the APU generator, turn those on. Those two generators on, I think we can turn our ground power off and get rid of our cart. I do believe. It's very possible we might be able to get rid of our stairs too. I'm just going to let that, see if those stairs kind of do their own thing. We'll find out. What if I don't even want to? If we need to, we'll get those stairs taken care of. But I think what I'm going to do is focus on the next engine now. Nobody saw me like you. I love you, and the minute you said behind the screen, it was all. This can come over back to the right side. Okay. Make sure we have our, I think we do have our parking brake. It's hard to say. I think it is. open it. Alright, so send that back to center. And now with the engines on, I think we're ready to. We've already got all our hydraulics on, so let's turn on our probe heats. We can certainly do our window heats as well. And at this point, I think we're ready now to keep these on. Turn the APU bleed off, and we can turn on our packs. Recirculate the air. Leave. We can turn those to nav. I guess we'll find out, won't we? That one I'm not 100% sure of. I think we're okay up here. Just doing a quick double check to make sure I'm not missing anything critical. Obviously, we need to get our seatbelt light on, but short of that. I guess we want to arm our emergency exit. Okay. It looks right to me. Oh, yaw damper. There we go. I think we're okay up here. That's what it looks like, at least. We'll see if those IRSs line now. I don't even know if we're going to use them, to be honest with you, because we're kind of just going to fly this thing by sight, I think. Oh, that is one thing I need to do. I think I need to move this to continuous. And I don't know if that goes off automatically or if I just need to clear it. Probably just need to clear it. Okay. See what else. I'm gonna remove the chocks. Make sure we don't start going anywhere. And it looks like the stairs are coming away. There we go. What's next? I'm gonna work a little bit on flaps. I think I'm gonna get us down to 5. Like the spoilers work, so let's put them back down. Okay. It's looking pretty good to me. Or trim. I think I'm going to start with that trim looks pretty good. I'm going to go a little further up though. Start there. Anything down here? I don't think so. Other than maybe our TCAS. Let's see what we got. Where's the TCAS? Right here. Transponder's on. Just want to see how. Okay, so by 10s, by 1s. ATC 1, transponder 1, that looks pretty good. We'll wait to see what our code is, and we'll be able to adjust it there. Frequencies, Gate on trims if we need them. Stabilizer trim is on normal, looks like, so that's good. Okay. I think we're ready for the next stage. Let's come up here to the glare shield and let's see, I gotta figure out. I think from what I remember from looking over the flight maps, I shouldn't say plan because there's really no plan that's happening here other than getting a general heading. And I believe the heading is, I probably ought to go the other way. Seems like it was like 303 or something like that. Getting a little excited here. I'm going to start with 303, and we'll start with an altitude of maybe like, I don't know, 13. I haven't successfully, or no, let's go 14. 14, 15. What the heck? I haven't successfully got the autopilot to work yet. So, we'll see how that goes. But I know we do need the flight director on to make anything work, so. Actually, that's auto throttle. Where's my flight director? It's like kind of in the same spot. There it is. Flight director on. Auto throttle. Okay. I don't know if we want that or not. Huh. I don't know. We'll put it on for now. But we'll take it off if we don't like it. That's it. Actually, I think this plane will let us do a pushback right out of the plane itself. Come on now. We're going to do a standard left. And I think 295 is going to work just fine. And let's select a tug. And let's start the sucker. See if I can get clearance. We're gonna go. We'll call it to the north.
Round head trip one.
It's probably really to the west.
Taxi for takeoff north departure.
Head trip one taxi two and hold short of runway 26 using taxiway. Contact tower on 118.1 when ready.
So we'll be using runway 26. Heading out this way, and then we'll have to kind of head up from there, so.
Taxi 2 and hold short runway 26 via taxiway head trip 1.
Still a little choppy on the frame rates, but.
Head trip one, did you hear my last transmission?
Hold position, head trip one.
I have a feeling by the time we hold, she's going to be ready to have us resume, but. We'll stop our pushback. We'll just wait for them to unconnect and move out of our way. We'll be on our way. Got someone playing around up there. Check that out. Sounds like he's got our tunes. Okay. This guy is clearly... Okay, he's gone now. I guess he wasn't going to go anywhere until we got rid of him, so... All right. Now we'll say this, let's see where our fuel is sitting at. That should be enough. That's plenty. It's not really that long of a flight today. Position. That doesn't. They better let us go or I'm going to go without their permission. Especially since I don't think we're holding for anything. I don't think I see anybody coming in. Looks like there's somebody up there maybe. Right up there. But it's hard to say. I don't see any lights. Either way, I think we're gonna head out. Take off our parking brake, which I think is already off. Yeah, I think we're good there. Guy up here is just a show off. I respect that. Takeoff clearance.
Tower head trip 1 ready for north departure at runway 26.
Head trip 1, altimeter 30.30, wind tree 8 at 8.
3030.
Cleared for takeoff runway 26.
Just going to adjust the barometer here. It's kind of some significant change in pressure. 3030. Okay.
Cleared for takeoff runway 26 head trip 1.
261. Okay, let's go. humid day. Do our own little turnaround here. So we get things slowed down here. That's a weird configuration, but we'll live with it. Okay. There we go. We're at 260 right now. So I guess really, I should probably have this down to 260. Started at 260 and then go from there. Altitude 1500, and then see if we can get that thing to engage. Rotate about at 180 knots, and I don't know if there's anything left to say. We'll get on our way. Okay. Here we go. There's 180. I'm going to see if this autopilot functions. I don't know how to do it. Trim this a little bit better here. Muggy day. think those are both where they need to be. Let's just take a double check. This gets a little dangerous when I start looking at stuff up here. Yeah, that looks good. Keep our speed in check. We're still at 180 knots, and we're climbing about 10 degrees. So, and as far as our direction, we're pretty close to on route. Need to make a few minor adjustments, and we'll be okay. We're only up to about 9,000 feet, so we're climbing slow, but we are raising in speed. This is where we're taking off from, Cayenne, and we're going to be moving over here in Suriname. To the international airport just below this major town. I can't remember what the name of the town is. Keep our trim up a little bit here. I would love to start to figure out how to get this darned autopilot cooperating. I don't think we can autopilot, maybe because we didn't program anything down in the FMC. That could be. I'm not sure if that's true or not. I don't know why that would be the case, but it could be. Does it not like this to climb that fast? I don't know why. Doesn't make sense. Oh, that's just telling us that we reached our target altitude. Cool. We're up to 16,000. Let it keep climbing slower. Pick up some speed, and then we'll do some more climbing. also like to play with my aileron trim because you can see that it keeps banking to the right, and that's probably because of wind. But I'd like to try to solve that problem. It's a little risky doing it because I don't want to get going too fast. I don't want to. It's this bad boy right here, left wing down. I think this is what we need. Let's see what happens. I may have done it. Okay, I need to bring up my flaps. That's big time. Probably should have done that quite a while ago. Now the speed's going to come up. Now we're moving. I think this thing has a cruise speed of about 452 true airspeed, so we'll see if we can settle into that. I'm going to drop my trim down. That should get us rock and rolling a little bit. Did I say something wrong? Did you hear what I was thinking? Did I talk way too long when I told you all my feelings that I... Is it you? Is it me? Did you find somebody better? Someone who isn't me? Cause I know that I was never your time. Never really your time. Nothing gonna go much higher than 25,000, 30,000 feet. Cause we're gonna be heading back down not too far after that. This is where we started running into problems last time. We don't want to stress the aircraft out too much because we're about at our top cruise speed. We just got to make sure we can level out without any dramatic increases in speed. And that's going to be playing with the trim a little bit, but. There's our cruise speed right there. Whoa, I think I'm even going to pull the throttles back just a tad. Not much. Maybe I'm about 95%. That'll just keep us a little safer, in my view. That for 1 second. Back to 5. Picking up speed again. Watch it. We'll be right back. Okay, we're going to start beginning a little more of a descent here. So I'm going to pull back on the throttle. I'm going to put some flaps on. I'll put another set of flaps on. down to 15,000. Gonna have to get a layout of land here of this airport. And I'm gonna try to. There's air runway 11 or 29. So. No stars. Airplane's not going down as fast as I thought it would, so I'm going to have to kind of force her. But we're going to be coming in pretty. Airport's just ahead. I'm going to try to line up with it as best we can and get down at a decent elevation. Let's see. Airports, what was the elevation of the airport? Roughly straight ahead, so let's give it a try. See, if it wasn't so freaking humid, I could see ahead, but I know it's up there. And it looks like we're fairly well on track for it. Put another set of flaps on. I think I'm going to drop my gear, so that's one less thing to worry about. Let's see if we can find this thing. There it is, right up there. love to get a visual on this thing. See that thing? There it is. There it is. Still looking for elevation for this runway on the chart. Can't be that hard. I know what we do. Elevation, elevation, elevation. 56 feet, so pretty much ground level. Okay, Suriname right ahead. Let's just see if we can make this happen without too much incident. Tricky. But if we can get there. Is not looking great. Might be a go around, guys. Yeah, I think it's gonna be a go around. It's fine. Better safe than sorry. I'm thinking we could put the nose wilt down just a tad. It could be a little dangerous, but... let's try it that way. Get the approach plate back on. That was super helpful. That's gonna work. Maybe. Most likely I'm gonna crash. I overshot that a little bit. We'll see. It's not over till it's over. Right? Speed, getting down to our elevation. Speed's still hanging in there. There we go, there we go. Come on down. Come on down. Much better. Still a little ugly, but it worked. And for whatever reason, my spoilers didn't come up. That was weird. Well, there they are now. Okay, Suriname. That knocks that one off. Figure out where we're going. Like this guy's gonna play chicken with me, so I don't know. He blinked. Not too many big airliners on this. Interesting. I'm pretty sure it's near an international airport. But this is it. This is all we got. I think we'll pull over here, give ourselves some space. There it is. Wow. Really? How long have you been looking at that? Well, I guess you watched it the boring way. That's stupid. Okay. Is what it is. Battery discharge. Yeah, I know. Let's get the APU off. Looks like it is. Okay. And there it is, our arrival into the second to the last country in South America. And you had to watch it all from a virtual air chart. Sorry about that. But better that than me not making it at all. So you saw it happen, though. You watched it. You watched me do the go-around, and you watched all that crap. So, okay. Well, thanks for joining. I guess we'll have one more jaunt over to Guyana, and then that's it. We're moving on. So, thanks for joining us here at Head Trip Bear World Tour, and hope you have a wonderful rest of your Labor Day holiday, and we'll catch you on the flip side, I guess. See ya.